Hello everyone and welcome back, and today I want to talk to you all about the mask. Now recently it has been announced that they want to make a mask reboot with a female lead, and right away people are freaking out about this and getting the wrong idea that this is once again another example of a let's take a character or movie that everyone likes, make them female, and then have some kind of feminist agenda. Well, as someone who has actually read the Mask comic and is a huge fan of it, I want to explain why I don't actually have a problem with the announcement of this reboot, and I want to get rid of a lot of misconceptions revolving around the Mask. Now, a lot of people only ever knew the Mask from the Jim Carrey movie from the 90s, and most of them don't even know that the Mask was originally a comic. And there are a lot of misconceptions because of this, one of them being that Stanley Ipkiss was the main character. However, contrary to popular belief, Stanley was not the main character in the comic. It was his girlfriend Kathy and Kellaway, the officer from the movie that was chasing Stanley. They were the main characters. Stanley actually dies really early on in the comic, because he originally bought the mask for his girlfriend Kathy, who did become the mask at some point. And she killed him after Stanley becomes abusive and power hungry after discovering the power of the mask and goes on a violent rampage, murdering a lot of people. So she kills him and gives the mask to Kellaway, so no one else can be harmed by it. And another thing people don't know about the mask is the mask is not actually the name of the mask character. His name was actually the Big Head Killer, but that's another thing a lot of people didn't know. See, the original Mask comic was actually a very dark, violent, gory comic in the same vein as something like Spawn or Deadpool. It's much more attuned to something like Deadpool than the goofy live-action cartoon that the movie was portrayed as. And, like I said, the main character was always Kathy, and later on in the story, she has an entire arc where Kathy does infiltrate a mafia that got their hands on the mask. In The Mask Returns, Kellaway is unfortunately attacked by members of the mob. They shoot him after he tries to dig up the mask to defend himself, and as a result, the mafia steals the mask, puts it on one of the goons, and he goes on a violent rampage using the power of the mask to rule the mob. When Kathy finds out about what happened to Kellaway and that the mask has ended up in the hands of a criminal, she goes to put a stop to it and does eventually get her hands on the mask and fights the mob with it, and even has a climactic showdown against the main antagonist, Walter. So, yes, there always was a female mask, and the mask was always led by a female character to begin with. Now, while it's true the other main character was Kellaway, and you could argue it would make sense to make it about him, but my argument is I don't think that this is the problem that people are making it out to be. People think that this is going to be another feminist agenda movie or something, or they're changing the sex of the mask for Mwamin power, but that's not the case at all. In fact, in the comic, Kathy actually hates the mask and doesn't want anyone to be harmed by its power. But I actually don't have a problem with this, because I actually personally would like to see the mask be rebooted to be much more like the comic, because The movie, while it is a perfect example of how to make a live-action version of something, completely change everything about it and still make it good, a lot of fans were disappointed that the Mask movies have little to nothing to do with the original comic, and I personally would love to see them make an accurate adaptation of the comic, and if that is their intent, then I am all for this reboot. If they're going for making the arc in The Mask Returns where Kathy steals the mask to go up against the mob, I would be all for it. It would make for a very interesting movie. You can show the fall of Kellaway and what the Mafia did to him, and Kathy throughout the movie trying to infiltrate the mob, getting the mask, and then fighting them and having the climactic showdown against Walter. That would be a fucking awesome movie, and I would personally love to see it. And if they make it much more accurate to the comic, considering the success of both Brightburn and especially Deadpool, I think it would be a perfect time for The Mask to be rebooted, because I'm hearing people saying that nobody wants to see a female reboot of The Mask. I disagree. I am a huge fan of The Mask comic, and I want to see The Mask be rebooted to be an accurate adaptation of the comic, and I would personally love to see the arc that focuses on Kathy, because she was a main character anyway. So I don't get why people are freaking out about this. I mean, I'm a huge fan of the comic. I would be one of the first people shitting on this if this was the case. And look, if they're going to try to remake the original Mask movie with just a female character, then I agree, that's stupid, there's no point in that. However, if their goal is to reboot it to make it more like the original comic, especially with the success of Deadpool, because the Mask comic is very similar to the Deadpool comic. So I think it would be a genius idea to try to bank on the success of characters like Deadpool, because the Big Head Killer is very much a Deadpool-esque character. And I don't have a problem with there being a female Mask, because guess what? There always was a female Mask. In fact, if you want to get precise, there was two female Masks. Later on in one of the other comics, The Hunt for Green October, a little girl gets her hands on the mask and becomes the Big Head Killer. So there actually is no issue here with making the Mask a female, because the whole thing is anyone can get their hands on the mask and become the Big Head Killer. It's a Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde-esque story. People use the mask for lots of different reasons. For Stanley, it was going on a violent rampage and getting revenge against the people he felt wronged him. For Kellaway, he tried to use the mask to do good. He wanted to use the mask to be a superhero like Stanley did in the movie, but unfortunately the power got too far and he almost killed his partner and gave up the power because he couldn't control it. Kathy gets the mask and becomes it, the Big Head Killer, so that way she can fix what she believes was her fault, because she believes that what happened to Kellaway was her fault because she was responsible for giving Kellaway the mask in the first place instead of trying to destroy it. So, for all of you who are complaining or frustrated with the announcement of this reboot, trust me, it's probably not what you think it is. Now, I will give you people this. If it is true that they're just trying to reboot the movie and not make an adaptation of the comic, I agree, that's stupid and that would piss me off. But if their goal is to make an accurate adaptation of the comic, then there is no issue here. I have no issue with the announcement of this reboot. I would love to see The Mask rebooted. I would love to see the arc where Kathy fights the mob in The Mask Returns comic. I would love it. I especially really want to see the fight between Big Head and Walter brought to life with state-of-the-art special effects like what we saw in the original Mask movie. I think that would be awesome. I would pay a ticket to see the movie just to see that fight from the comic come to life alone. So, take it from me, people, someone who has read the original Mask comic. This is not as big of a deal as you think, and there is a good chance that this reboot is actually being made with the purpose of adapting the comic, which in and of itself is not a problem. But what do you all think? Do you think I'm wrong? Do you think I'm being a little bit too forgiving because I am a fan of the original comic? Or are you with me and you think that these people that are concerned about this are freaking out over nothing because they're getting the wrong idea and have very little information on the original comic? Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. I would absolutely love to discuss this because, like I said, I really do love this comic. It's one of my favorite comics of all time, and I'm so excited I get to talk about it, even if it's talking about a kind of controversy. But I'll see you guys around for the next video.
I'm looking for some help. I need someone to save my ass.